Hello, this is Tipper Gore. Thank you for letting me speak with you about an issue critical to our nation's future, how to provide health security to every American family. Since the President launched his task force on health care, we've been working around the clock. We have brought in over 500 people with real-world expertise from around the country, including doctors, nurses, and people who are experts just because they get health care. One woman from Virginia told us about her unsuccessful 11-year struggle to purchase a supplemental insurance policy for herself and her husband. She suffers from a degenerating spine, and her husband has multiple sclerosis. She told us, "When someone is disabled, as he and I are, and when you are discriminated against by insurers through no fault of your own, it does terrible things to your mental health and reinforces that you are truly disabled." We've also met with hundreds of groups who represent all the different views on this issue, from doctors to hospitals to businesses to consumers. These groups share our belief that we must work together to make our healthcare system work for every American. Today, 100,000 people a month are losing their health insurance. Millions more are worried that they will be denied coverage because of a pre-existing condition or lose their insurance if they switch jobs. Millions more have none at all. The simple fact is, health care must become a right, not a privilege, in this great country. I know what the security of having quality medical care means to families, because I almost lost my son 4 years ago. My son Albert was struck by a car after watching a baseball game in Baltimore. He had serious injuries, but wonderful doctors and nurses to take care of him, and he pulled through. That experience taught me how lucky I am to have coverage for my family. I look at healthcare not just as a mother and a concerned citizen, but as someone with a long-time interest in mental health. Every day we learn ways that mental illness can be treated or at least brought under control to allow the mentally ill to become productive members of society. People need to realize that 1 in 5 families are affected by a mental illness. We now have a window of opportunity to bring the reality of medical science in line with health policy. I am proud to be part of an administration that wants to make sure that all people with mental illness get a chance to compete in society without prejudice or discrimination. An administration that wants to see the Americans with Disabilities Act implemented. And an administration that knows that treatment for mental health is not only the right thing to do, it is also the smart thing to do. With all the changes we must make, some things will remain the same. We will preserve the best of the current system, the best doctors in the world, superior technology, the individual's right to choose a doctor, and the highest quality care. But there's plenty that you won't see under a new system. You won't see insurance companies turning people away because of a pre-existing condition. You won't hear of people who lose their job and can't find coverage. And you won't have to fill out form after form if you're a patient or a doctor. And you won't see prescription drugs that are out of reach for middle-class Americans. Throughout the campaign, and since the President asked us to work on this issue, I've been talking to people about the need for comprehensive health care reform. And they all say one thing, that we must act now. So I ask you to join with us as we seek fundamental change in America's health care system to provide a secure future for ourselves and our children. Thank you all very much.